On August 4 of this year, the world of three-time and defending AMA Pro Superbike champion Josh Hayes went completely upside down.
Oh, and look at that! Hayes goes down! Hayes, as the leader, goes down!
That's live. Plus, the frustrating moments it took to get out of the sand trap and on his way resulted in an 18th place finish, adding insult to what had become his toughest season to date. His weekend had started to turn sour the day before when he was beaten by protege and teammate number two, Josh Herrin. The battle had raged for 16 laps, with Herrin seizing the checkers, Hayes finishing an uncharacteristic third.
I just got beat today.
You will recall that Hayes' charge to a record-setting fourth consecutive title had started miserably at Daytona when he failed to finish either race, leaving Florida with but 9 points.
My Daytona sucked.
Since then, his recovery had been nearly flawless, a world-beating performance.
Josh Hayes wins again here in 2013.
But on that 100-degree day at Miller Motorsports Park in Salt Lake City, Utah, he would again leave a racetrack without the points lead, as blue as his number one Yamaha.
It got the best of me this time. I ran out of talent. It's not over yet. We still got three races at racetracks I'm good at, and I'm looking forward to going racing again.
For Herrin, his third career Superbike win represented what he considered to be his first real win.
Oh, what a race this has been as they come now onto that long straightaway and under the checker, and Josh Herrin has his win.
His premier checker had come at Daytona after Hayes dropped out, and his second at Mid-Ohio, courtesy of a Hayes starting foul that resulted in a 5-second penalty.
Hayes has the lead in the hole shot, but he could get penalized for that.
His win at Miller, however, had been hard fought. Hayes and fellow points contender number 36, Martin Cardenas, being beaten fair and square.
Yeah, it feels amazing. It's also nice to come in and know that I won the race.
So, Josh Herrin comes to round 7 of the 2013 Geico Motorcycle Road Racing Series as the AMA Pro Superbike points leader, with teammate and presumed champion Josh Hayes behind him by double digits. For the moment, at least, the student has become the master.
You know, it's a big mountain that I climbed over. We just got to treat it like any other race and not stress about a championship and just try and go out there and get the most points that we can, try and get the pole award and try and have fun. You know, that's the biggest thing, trying to have fun. I know that coming into this weekend, I'm more prepared than I have been the past 6 years and my training's stepped up a bunch and I feel, you know, mentally ready and so I think it's gonna be a good weekend.
So might the star of one Josh have reached its apogee and started to climb, while the star of the other Josh started toward ascension? We'll see just how those stars align, but moments from now. The P-47 Thunderbolt, one of the most powerful and devastatingly effective propeller-driven fighters ever developed. When the bad guys saw this bird heading their way, they knew they had trouble. Today, we find ourselves at a racetrack named after that fearsome machine of war. One of two tracks at the New Jersey Motorsports Park in Millville, where the combat is far less lethal, but just as determined for round 7, race 1 of the National Guard AMA Pro Superbike Championship presented by Yamaha. The rest of the afternoon, we will bring you the side-by-side two-wheeled action in both the Superbike and Sport Bike divisions, with the emphasis going to the big bombers, if you will, of the sport, the 1,000cc Superbikes. A magnificent piece of machinery, isn't it? I'm Paul Page. Welcome to the CBS Sports Network and our continuing coverage of AMA Pro Championship Racing. Along with AMA and World Superbike champion Scott Russell and our expert pit reporter, Danielle Teal, we'll be covering the story of a title chase in Superbike and the struggles of one man who just doesn't know the meaning of the word surrender. Scott?
The challenge here keeps mounting the pressure as well, Josh. You've had a couple of issues leading into this race. Saw you pushing the bike in a couple times this morning. Can you tell us a little bit about what's going on?
I don't really know. We've just had a rough weekend, and, it seems like we've had two in a row. You know, Miller was a tough weekend for us. We come here, we're fast. You know, we're on pole fast early in the session, got up to speed quickly. But, it's definitely a bit challenging. You have a couple of malfunctions. I tore up a motorcycle. I started this problem. So, you know, at the end of the day, it comes down on me, but I'm looking forward to the race. I know I have a good motorcycle underneath me, and it's been a good track to me, so let's see if I can turn it around and put the pressure back on them again.
Well, for a season that's much different than the past three for this guy, keep your eye on Josh Hayes. He's still running strong this weekend. Danielle?
Thanks, Scott. We're just getting things warmed up down here. A guy who put down a real serious effort at Miller Motorsports Park was the number 54, Roger Hayden. Roger, you have a shot to be a real spoiler here today.
Yeah, things have been going good. The National Guard, Michael Jordan Motorsports team has been working hard. We have nothing to lose, so we're going to be going for it.
Paul?
Yeah, and that is one guy who could really, as Danielle said, become the spoiler. But let's consider Josh Hayes and his record here. Well, if history is prologue, based on history, Hayes is the guy. But this weekend has been a little tough for him. We'll be back.
AMA Pro Superbike on CBS Sports Network is brought to you by 1-800-MOTORCYCLE. The lawyers at 1-800-MOTORCYCLE remind you to ride safe tonight. 1-800-MOTORCYCLE, lawyers helping injured riders. Call or click anytime for a free consultation. And by Yamaha. Yamaha is the first name in motorsports.
It was a toss-up for the AMA Pro Superbike Championship going into the final race of the final round at New Jersey in 2011. Blake Young held a 5-point advantage over Josh Hayes with two races remaining. Hayes won the first race and regained the points lead by 11. But it was the second race that dramatically decided the title. Young took over the lead with 6 laps remaining, with Hayes dropping back to fourth, a 15-point difference. With just a few turns remaining on the final lap, Young had a 2-point advantage for the championship. Then, Ben Bostrom went wide, and Hayes jumped all over Roger Hayden for second. In just a matter of a couple of hundred yards, Hayes had moved up 2 spots and defended his title.
Hi, I'm Neil Hudson, the 2003 World Superbike Champion. It's good to see my old mate Josh Hayes still doing a bit of winning back out there in America. You can catch it all on CBS.
And the Brit won his championship on a Ducati. Let's take a look at the current points, because after Salt Lake City, everything changed. Josh Herrin moved up to number 1. Martin Cardenas, he's now 2nd. Hayes is 15 points back in 3rd. And Roger Hayden still has a mathematical shot at becoming the champion, as we show you down all the way through the top 10. Now, what has to happen before this championship fight? We've got a bunch of scenarios for you, but I think that second one, if Herrin wins one race, finishes 2nd in the other 2, then he will win by 6 points. But there is still a very long way to go in this championship. And this man, Martin Cardenas, hailing from Colombia, is the man who might just benefit the most from the brewing family feud between the two blue Yamahas. The man on the white and blue number 6 Suzuki just coincidentally happens to be this week's next Moto champion.
I love racing here in the AMA. It feels like a second home to me, especially with my friends Stefano Mesa and Tommy Puerta. The thing is that we've been racing since we were kids, and we know each other because we are from the same town. But I think all of us are trying to do our best in each of the classes, so been like that?
I mean, Martin's like my older brother. We've been together since I was pretty much born. I mean, my family and his family are pretty much always together. We go to Christmas together. I mean, it's more like a family. So, I mean, if I have any problems through the weekend, he's always there to help me.
Between race weekends and stuff like that, we are a little bit more relaxed and we like to do like the same stuff. And we're a little different than Americans, but we have fun.
Oh yeah, definitely nice because they speak Spanish, so it's a lot easier for us to speak in the native language.
Of course, Martin Cardenas races on 36, and he just might be the next Moto champion. All right, looking ahead to this run, what are we going to watch for, Scott?
Well, obviously, Hayes is riding for the win. That's the first thing you have to watch for. Obviously, he wants to win the championship. Herrin, same thing. Riding hard to win, and Cardenas, the same thing. That's what these three guys got to keep in mind. If any of them want to be champs, that's what they need to do here today.
They have no choice but to go flat out and go for the checkered flag first. Well, as they take the warm-up, let's take a look at the field, and here is the starting grid. John Hayes set a new track record in taking the number one shot. And the front row, that's the entire battle for the race. We look back in the back rows. David Anthony had a whale of an off this morning, and we'll deal with that a little bit later. Here's the racetrack.
Well, you can see this thing's 14 turns, 0.2 miles in length. It's a real challenge for the racers, and you know, it's got some, it's got a little bit of elevation change, and that always gives a track character. So I think it's going to be a great race today here in New Jersey. So there you have it.
14 turns, 2.2 miles. We're ready to go. The front row is the battle for the championship. They're off. Now they head for that very, very fast left right-hander. And you can sweep wide on this thing, but you do have to get down on the brakes. And look at Josh Hayes, way back.
He's got issues, I think. Something looks like it's wrong with the bike, possibly. He did not get the jump off the line, and he continues to go backwards here.
Well, they had a problem twice this morning with the electrical system on the bike. They thought they had it fixed. Look at that.
Unbelievable. Look here. Look at Hayes. That's Hayes. That's
Herrin
as well.
Both of the leading Yamahas have trouble right on the start. And it was something, well, if, you know, you talk to the crew, they tell you what's going on. And maybe both bikes have the same problem, and if so, it's electrical.
Well, Hayes' bike's running again. Now Herrin is not. Herrin's the one that's got the worst end of this deal so far, but with electrical issues, it could come back at any time.
Well, Hayes had his first, so the field got past him right on the start, and then Herrin suffered his problem a little bit later. Here's the start
right.
Once again.
Keep your eye on Hayes over here on the far right. He's going to get off the line pretty good, and then all of a sudden the bike wheelies up, and at that point it loses power or something's going on. He goes straight to the back.
And
you can see Josh Herrin in the middle of the field. He's in fifth or sixth, not so bad.
So the two motorcycles that started first and second on the front row of the grid have almost simultaneous failures, and that puts them well back in the field. So now Cardenas is going to be wondering from his lead position, where are those other two? Are they sneaking up on me? I wish I had mirrors. I'd like to know what's back there.
We got Hayes again. And we got real issues out here with these Yamahas right now. These Graves bikes have definitely got some issues. You see Chris Ulrich pulling off in turn three right now, and then Hayes back in turn three right now, trying to get going again.
There's a desperate crew. They're wondering what's happening too. Trying to make decision on what they can do.
There's our kind of drama going on out here right now.
This is exactly what we were looking for, though.
I know.
You set this stage. Hayes has his problems at Salt Lake City. He dominates here, but then once he gets here, he has two problems on two different motorcycles. And now he has this problem, as does Herrin. Danielle?
The number one has been chasing electrical problems all weekend, and it looks like it might be much of the same issue going on. Any idea, and how do we recover?
Well, I'm not sure exactly what happened there. We didn't get to see it until just now, but you know, we prepared the bike best we can, and we're putting pieces back together. It hasn't gone smooth, but we're still collecting points, so that's the plan.
Yeah, but you need to collect a basket full of points if you really want to get back into this game. And so that at the front of the field puts the Colombian Martin Cardenas and Roger Hayden right behind him. And this is going to prove to be a nice fight up at the front as well.
Well, this is definitely a fight between three Suzukis now. Danny Essick bringing up that third spot on the 23, not in camera shot there, but that'll be three Suzukis out front, and the Yamahas are nowhere to be found. And that's unfortunate. You know, when you got an electrical problem like that, you don't know, and the bike runs, it stops running. You know, these bikes are so electronically advanced now that you just never know when it's going to go wrong in the middle of a corner and flick you off the thing as well.
Well, and when you think about it now, the leader of the race, Martin Cardenas on the 36, and second place, Roger Hayden on the 54, they are in at the edge of the points fight, but with the two Yamahas going away early, and assuming they don't really get back in to get a lot of points, this is going to change things even further in that fight for the championship.
Well, for Martin Cardenas right now, he's the guy right now that he could, at this point, if things go the way ahead, it looks like he will probably take over the championship points lead. And here we go back to Josh Hayes here.
Back to the number two bike of Herrin. The two Joshes, you know.
Yeah, it's hard.
14th position, that is. He is back in 14th place, believe it or not, racing with Chris Ulrich. Now he moves to 13th. Wow, what a change of events right at the start of this race. Though in a way it was predicted because they did have trouble in that team this morning and yesterday. Now the points as they stand right now, and we're going to track this for you because it's going to change constantly, and it has Cardenas up number one. Herrin, who has dropped from his lead position, is back 13 points. Hayes remains in third, back 27. Hayden, well, it's outside, but there's a chance. You do a lot of arithmetic. I mean, we call it arithmetic in my day, not mathematics. Yeah.
I'll leave that up to y'all experts. I'm just going to watch the race here. See what happens.
Let's go to Danielle.
This is a very important race for the number two and number one, and they both had issues off the start and are still having issues and trying to recover. Any idea, was there anything earlier in the weekend that may have led to this?
No idea at all. We didn't see any of the TV on the first lap, so I have no idea what happened. All I saw was the splits were all messed up, and obviously came out in last place on the first lap. So. Hopefully he can make up some places. It's not looking real good at the moment, but his lap times are good, so we'll see how it plays out.
Well, Yates has gotten around Taylor Knapp and now has moved up into the fight as well, so he sits up now in third place. Here's the start again. Watch the two Yamahas. First one fails, then the other.
It's about second or third gear where it looks like things start to go wrong on the Hayes bikes. I think we're in that, but never, I don't see Hayes out there right now at all, but I see Herrin right now. He's making some headway. It looks like he's the quickest rider on the racetrack right now, or one of them.
And back to the front of the field. There is your leader. It's the 36 of Martin Cardenas. But right behind him, Roger Hayden. And again, I don't think we can emphasize this enough. These two guys are very much in the fight and getting closer and closer in the points as the Yamahas have their problems. So we are underway for the 23 laps complete, and it's been action all the way. We'll be right back. Well, we come back with a fairly familiar shot at New Jersey Motorsports Park. That's Josh Hayes, number one. What's unfamiliar is that he is way, way back in the field, currently out of the top 10, and his teammate Herrin is back there as well due to problems on the start. They've had electrical problems all weekend. Looks, though, like it's running better now.
It does. I'm not sure, what happened here. Obviously, here we go again. We'll have another look. As he goes to about third gear, second gear, the bike wheelies. And at that point, it just looks like it loses power.
And with that start, by the way, the AMA officials have penalized 5-second penalty to Hayes, the 23 of Eslick, and the 75 of Nash for problems on the start.
It's a strange deal, you know. It's like did he know he jumped the start and just decided to let everybody go by? No, you don't let people go, that many guys go by, if you feel like you jumped the start. He's been through this. Now he's coming up on a group of riders right here.
Yeah, Larry Beckert is first in line for him. And then just ahead is Chris Clark. So Clark and Pagan are going to be the first victims.
Oh, that guy.
Whoa, you got to know he's there. Yeah. You know, there's the other problem, isn't it? Because you got a much faster bike. and he's going to close on guys that don't expect it.
Well, that 72 bike is supposed to be the same bike he's riding, okay? But nevertheless, that's a tricky little spot, and a rider really maybe not have been expecting that, Larry Pagram, but Josh hadn't got any time to fool around with these guys.
Not at all.
He's got to
like
quick work of them and salvage as many points as he can right now.
Larry Pagram, who he got past, is the 72 out of Hebron, Ohio. And Hayes now begins to motor away. He's got a very long way to go. Somewhere back just behind him, we ought to see the two bike as well, because Herrin is back there as well. Back up at the front of the field, it's Cardenas and Hayden, one and two. And they've kind of stayed in that same relative position.
They have. Hayden has closed the gap, though. That gap used to be a bit larger. For Cardenas, he's going to want to stay in front. He needs to get as many points as he can. He's not going to want to get this up to the 54 right now.
Well, like we said at start, though, they all need wins. And certainly most of all of those, is Roger Hayden.
True. So Roger knows that just as we do, and he's going to be fighting this hard. And there's Josh Herrin right here.
There's Herrin on the number two bike. Herrin is back in the field as well. Let's look back and find him.
Looks like we got some smoke right
now.
Here.
Yeah,
we might have an issue here in turn two.
Something off the track?
You can see somebody standing off the back side of the track.
And that's, there it is.
Huntley Nash, unfortunately.
Yep. Nash, of course, one of those that was also penalized on the start. And now it's off the side of the course. Good eye caught the smoke. Well,
yeah, let's just hope that it didn't oil the track down. And it did.
Uh-oh.
He's lucky to save it. Now we got a problem with the other riders coming around this next lap. So
you got to go yellow on that turn.
You might need to go red, and there
red.
It is.
There it is. You can't take that chance.
Oh, wow. So now this is some drama now.
So we have the red flag out. Who knows where this is going now? Because they're all going to bunch up again and do a restart. It's going to be cool. We'll be back. Welcome back to the beautiful New Jersey Motorsports Park, Millville, New Jersey. Geico Motorsport AMA Pro Road Racing. And earlier, Danielle Teal caught up with Josh Hayes.
Talk to you in a little bit.
Josh, I know you're not in a very good place right now in your head. I'm sure you don't want to say much, but can you give us an idea of what was going on out there with your bike?
I don't really know. We had a little issue. The bike wouldn't run. I had to cycle the switch on the front straight. I don't understand the jump start. I'm going to ask some questions.
There you go.
Wow. Well, for those of you who might have missed the pregame on Friday night, Scott did a piece on starts that we think we ought to show you now.
To start one of these motorcycles, when you come around off the siding lap, you pull up to your mark on the line here, you're not allowed to move. Back in the old days, they would allow you some leeway where you could roll the bike forward a little bit before the light came on. Those days are gone.
Here's a look at the start earlier and exactly how that worked out. Now watch the front wheels. That's what counts, Scott.
Yeah, because it's just a little bit of movement by the one, and wow, that's a couple of times this year that caught him out, and now he'll start this race with an unfortunate 5-second penalty.
And what they're going to do is reform a grid based on the positions they were in at the time that the red flag came out. And this is why we have the red flag. Oil all over this racetrack. I mean, a lot of oil. That's Nash, and boy, when that thing let go, it put oil everywhere.
It did. He's lucky he was able to stay on that.
So now take a look at this, because Herrin and Hayes are well back in the field in the third row. We're off again. We're running. There are 13 laps to go. Cardenas gets the early jump.
That was so close down on the inside. Josh Herrin went down the inside of his teammate, decided I'm going to back off a little bit, let Josh have it. But he ran into the back of his teammate right there, and that caused Hayes to bobble and fall back deeper into the crowd.
And now Hayes is caught in with many slower bikes. Here's what happened.
Take a look down the inside. You can see the two. He's kind of got in there on the tight line. He and the one come together. Oh, and,
wow.
And then Roger Hayden had a part of that. Maybe Herrin didn't touch him at all, but Hayden and Hayes came together, and now Hayes has got more work to do.
Well, now, one thing we do know is it's some very tight racing and some very desperate racers out there.
Well, he's under the gun right now. He wants to make up as many positions as he can quick. This is a shortened race. We only got 13. We got 12 to go when they come by this time. So Josh has got to make some moves quick, especially after that little bobble.
And we'll keep an eye on the number one Yamaha of Josh Hayes, who has now moved up into seventh place. So he's up three positions from where he was when it began. And look at this. Herrin has been able to move all the way to the front. And now Herrin is the leader of this race. Boy, a lot of developments just on the restart after the red flag for oil.
Well, this is the first time through one and two at speed here, Paul. Let's see how they all negotiate. This is the oil spill area right here. Looks like the AMA's done a pretty good job, real good job actually cleaning that up. Took a while, but there was a lot of oil.
So here they are, Herrin, Cardenas, Hayden, and Yates. One, two, three, and four. Herrin, of course, he needs to do everything perfectly. He can come away with a championship. We told you that at the start of the show. It depends on what he does, which is have to be almost perfect, while at the same time, he has to count on Josh Hayes having some problems, and he certainly is right now.
Well, the battle's heating up between the two Jordan Suzuki's back there. The 54 and the 23 are going at it.
Let's go to Danielle Teal.
A very interesting race so far for Josh Herrin, the number two. Tisha, as a fiance, where was his head really at? Was he telling you anything he wasn't telling us, or was he calm as he was acting?
He was pretty calm. There was nothing that was, you know, not said with you guys. He works really good under pressure, and I think he's going to do great.
Well, Herrin with Cardenas all over him now.
Yeah, pressure is what he got right now from behind in the way of the 36, and then Danny Essick on the 23, who's desperate to have a good show in here, and he's got a good run on the 36 down the inside. Nothing gonna happen there.
So as we track the points throughout the race, this is the way they stand right now, with Herrin 14 out in front now. Hayes has dropped back 38 behind the leader,
but he's caught the lead group at that time, so he is right there now in the fifth spot as they make their way through that tricky turn three. We've seen a lot of riders fall down over the top of this hill right here. These Superbikes going to launch off that thing and flick it into this right, a hard breaking left coming up.
2 points, about 9.5 laps to go. And don't forget, Hayes has a 5-second penalty that he's riding with right now.
So that's why he's riding with such a sense of urgency. He knows he's 5 seconds in deficit to these guys already. So he's got to try and get around him as quick as possible. But you know, this could be his day. With the way things have shaken out, the way the first part of the race looked, did not look good for him.
So at the front, it remains Herrin, Cardenas, Hayden. And now, of course, we're seeing Josh Hayes in a bid for his fourth unprecedented championship. But it's an uphill fight for him now. He needs to get out in front. He needs to win this thing.
Well, it looks like Cardenas is looking for a way around the two. Everybody's queued up behind the number two right now. So the pace that he's running is a pace that everybody seems to be able to stay with. And look at Essex. He's down there looking.
Oh, man. Right down in there. That's amazing. Look at this group battle together. Five of them.
For Josh Hayes, this is tough because it's one of the most difficult racetracks to pass on. So here they are. Hayes, Herrin got a little shaky over the top of the hill right there. He's slowing the pace down right now. Everybody's queued up behind him.
Now continuing to count down through the laps. Long red flag changed a lot of things, especially where they put the bikes in the grid when they restarted the race. Look at this. A little too wide for Herrin.
That was a good move by Hayden. He had to get down the inside of his teammate, Essex. He tried that a couple of laps ago. It did not work out for him. He muscled his way by Danny that time. Looked for Danny to try to repay that favor, but Roger's quick.
So Herrin and Cardenas, they battle at the front. And there is Josh Hayes, who right now is trying to get through this group, which is running very fast, and get up to the front, maybe take on his teammate. I asked Hayes about pressure. I said, what? How do you feel? Are you under pressure now? He said, no, I'm not under pressure at all. I got everything. I got a contract. I'm good. The guys who are under pressure are the guys who are trying to beat me.
Okay. Well, I like that. That's
probably a good attitude.
Yeah, it's a good attitude. I mean, he's got his back. Three championships. Here we go. Martin made it happen. Finally.
Back again. Yeah. Well, Martin comes back to the front, puts Herrin back to second. Tatum sitting right behind him on the 54. And Josh Hayes, who is at the back of this little group, the fifth bike in the row, has not been able to make up any position at all.
front straight away, the 36. They've had a good run. Roger looked down the inside, too. He thought, maybe I'll make the move. Really not a lot of room. You don't want to try to pass two guys from that far back. Martin made it look textbook easy right here. He got the good draft on the Yamaha. The Yamahas are quick. Suzuki's are right there.
Hayden tries it to the inside. Not going to happen there, but Hayden is definitely working on this as well.
There it is.
Wow.
Payback. And it's on now.
We're going to go back and forth and hammer side by side. Oh, this is some terrific racing. And before, what the track thought would be a record-breaking crowd here at New Jersey Motorsports Park. And it is jammed.
A great place to have a race. There's a great track, and you got New York. They got a lot of draw. Here we go, Herrin down the inside. Wow.
Herrin comes back to the front again as they come onto the front stretch.
You don't see a lot of passing going on right there. That was a brave move for him to stick it in there like that.
Normally, you see him pass right here in one or over in six. That was a pretty, that was a spectacular move.
And Hayes made something happen as well on that deal. He's moved up on past Danny Essen.
Remember, though, every time you look at Hayes, you got to just visually move him 5 seconds further back. There are your top four. Interestingly enough, they are the fight in the championship right now. So, out in front is Josh Herrin. Can he hold on to that position? Can he keep his hopes for a championship alive? We'll be back. Josh Hayes moved forward, got into third place, came up alongside Cardenas, tried him once, didn't get it done. Herrin is still the leader, but look at this top five. This is an incredible race you're watching right now. And we're talking the championship battle, 1, 2, 3, and 4. Those are the top four guys. And look at the top three.
I tell you, man, it's a battle royale right here, and they're trying to contain the number one right now. Being 5 seconds off right now. They got to keep him behind us. Here we go. Down into turn six, the 36. Out breaks the two. Just set him up perfectly right there.
And then two came right back at it.
Come right back at him. Down the front straightaway, they go at each other again. I mean, it's just back and forth right now. And Hayes is the guy that continues to move forward, picking them off one at a time.
And as they scream for that first turn, they're traveling better than 175 miles an hour. Wow, Cardenas back in front. And now Josh Hayes tries to make a move on his teammate, Josh Herrin. So it's a Josh battle for second place.
It really is. And you know, like I said, they want to keep him back there. They're not really thinking about Josh Hayes right now. They're worried about each other, everybody they're racing with. So for Hayes, he's trying to get by and reel that 5 seconds back in that he's lost.
And look at the points now. Nothing much has changed with his positioning. Herrin is still out in front by 14 over Cardenas. And Josh Hayes, who for the most of the season we thought was going to be the champion, he's back in third in the points.
I tell you, all these guys are really riding hard. You can see them just, the bikes are all over the place.
I mean, is he losing grip? We're seeing him bobble quite a bit.
Yeah, they're just riding that hard. They're getting on the throttle that hard. They're twisting and turning on the handlebars. Twisting the handlebars in their hands and trying to make the bike counter steer. So they're getting aggressive. There's a lot right here. So anytime you're on the accelerator and you're trying to change direction, the bike gets light. But yeah, the tires are slipping. The traction control is catching it. It's upsetting the motorcycle, but these guys aren't bothered by that one bit.
Really? It bothered me. Let's go to Danielle.
The number 36, Martin Cardenas, says that he never feels the pressure in these races. We're seeing a little bit of a bobble right now. He desperately needs a win. Are we seeing the pressure starting to get to him?
Oh, for sure. I mean, the three guys are all fighting for the championship here, and there's a fair bit of oil out in the track. It's quite slippery in a few places. Tires have been hot and cold all afternoon trying to get the race done. So, as you can see, the pace is a bit slower due to the track conditions. So, yeah, I'm not surprised that they all look a little bit out of control.
Well, as you talked about earlier, choice of tires turned out to be quite critical here. But I don't know, and there we go. Another pass. And we'll see if Cardenas can come back. No. First, Herrin makes that stick, and now Josh Hayes is going to try to make it stick.
Cardenas is going to fight back, though. He's not giving it up that easy. He knows that he can't allow these Yamaha guys to get away. But as Peter Doerr alluded to, the fact that these tires have been heat cycled, so that's having an issue with some of the movement you're seeing right.
We look at that again.
Well, coming on the fresh straightaway, Josh, that's two times that he's made that move. And that opened the door for Hayes, but then Cardenas got it regrouped and got back down the inside of him to hold him off. So some awesome racing right here.
So now it's Herrin, Cardenas, and Hayes. One, two, three. Battle for the championship. Hayden is up there as well, but just a few feet off of the battle for first, second, and third. And they are now beginning to run out of time. So you pass here, or do you think out your strategy for the final lap? How do you approach it?
For Hayes, I want to pass as soon as I can, anywhere I can. I got to try to get back that 5 seconds, and time is ticking away. For the other two, you keep that thing as wide as you can. I mean, they're both looking forward. They're not looking back. So the 36 is one going to get it right around the two as soon as he can and just keep this battle going. There's no time to really think about strategy at this point because there's somebody breathing down your neck behind you.
And, you know, it is our policy, and we love to cover racers back in the field. With this fight at the front, I'm sorry, we have not been able to do that. This has just been so good, and there you got another one again. You've got another pass again. Cardenas goes back to the front.
Colombian means business today. He's tired of getting beat up by these Yamaha riders all year long, and he's had a couple good runs, but to beat him outright, this could be it right here for him today.
Cardenas retakes the lead. Herrin is all over him. Hayes is all over Herrin. Hayden sits back and watches this battle for the front. Man, this is some good stuff.
The tough thing about this track, there's only a couple of decent spots to make a move. So if you're going to do it, it's going to have to be something like that. And you're going to have to surprise attack the guy. And that's exactly what Herrin's doing. He's riding the rest of his life right now.
Now, the thing I got to remind you is you watch Hayes come down on the inside. Remember, that bike is really 5 seconds further back. He's riding with a 5-second penalty. So that may be as far back as fifth when we come to the finish.
Teammate got a little wide there. Herrin ran it a little bit wide, but is able to salvage that and get back and stay in the front. This is right the section where Herrin's very aggressive riding style can cost him some time. Another look here as Herrin muscles his way through in turn 7, and that opens the door in turn 8 for Hayes to follow him right through there.
Just inches away at well over 150 miles an hour back through those corners. And here comes Hayes. Hayes comes to the front, comes around his teammate, and takes the lead. What an incredible run. What an incredible day. Now, he physically has the lead. He's out in front, but again, through the 5 seconds. Going to go back to fourth right now.
Herrin.
Whoa.
Oh, out of the saddle on the throttle right there. The thing kicked him back out right there. He's trying hard. He knows he didn't want the one to get away, and he made a mistake right there.
Well, and we're so close to the end of the championship, even the tiniest of mistakes can make a huge difference.
Yeah, let's take another look. As he come out of three A and B right here, turn it into four right here on the throttle. The back end steps out on that Yamaha. Traction control caught it just in time. But he lost time and position.
So while we, in theory, have Hayes out in front, I mean, he's doing what he needs to do. He's trying to elongate his position as it relates to second place. He needs a 5-second gap if he wants to win this race. Looks like he's trying to do it. Right now, though, Hayes is in fourth.
At this point, the way he's going, he might be able to pull 5 seconds on him right now. I mean, if they keep battling it out with each other, it's going to cost him.
Let's go to Danielle.
Like you said, Paul, it may look like Josh Hayes is in first place, but he is actually running in fourth due to the penalty. Jim, going into the restart, was there a strategy? Was it done totally out the window? Is it all about salvaging points?
The strategy going back to the restart was getting the lead and stretch out by 5 seconds or more and see if we can win this thing. We got caught up in some traffic, and obviously, he's got a little bit of gap now. We're finally made it to the front. Tough traffic to pass at, and then we're obviously seeing that, and it's hurting us a little bit.
Now, is Josh probably the guy that could go out there and actually make up the 5-second gap?
Yeah, he could be pretty quick. He just turned to 21, so it's the only one on the board turning 21, so hopefully.
All right, on the final lap now, and as we do that, remember, you need a 5-second interval for Hayes to win this thing. Otherwise, it's going to belong to Herrin, and Herrin will take the winner's share of the points here. And there, once again, are the points they are right now. And nothing has changed from the in the points, really, from the way we started this race. Right. Cardenas, 36. He is, in theory, the winner, unless Hayes can get the 5 seconds.
Well, here he comes. This is it. The last time by.
Coming from the finish line, Hayes is going to physically be out in front. But is he out in front enough? No, it does not look like it. 2, 3, yeah, not at all.
Not enough.
Let's make it as a win for that guy right there, right at the last. Herrin got around Cardenas.
Now, he doesn't know where he's finished right now, but according to the time he scored, he won the race. And Josh Hayes stays in that fourth spot.
So much has happened here today. We'll review it when we come back.
AMA Pro Superbike on CBS Sports Network is being brought to you by 1-800-MOTORCYCLE. The lawyers at 1-800-MOTORCYCLE remind you to ride safe tonight. 1-800-MOTORCYCLE, lawyers helping injured riders. Call or click anytime for a free consultation. And by GEICO. 15 minutes could save you 15% or more on motorcycle insurance. Get a free rate quote today.
Well, we've seen an amazing race. There's still two more to go. This is the start. You see Hayes as he rolled forward. That cost him 5 seconds right there as the field headed for the first turn. His crew really concerned because of problems they were having with the electrical system. And then out in front is Cardenas with everybody else chasing him.
Big move down in the inside. Those two battled it out the whole way home.
That's after the restart. We had a red flag for a while there, and then almost off the bike. But here is the finish with Hayes physically out in front, but less than 5 seconds back is Herrin, and he has the win. Danielle?
Still leading the championship by 19 points over Martin Cardenas is Josh Herrin. Josh, having an incredibly difficult race, a lot of variables in there. Can you give us a little synopsis of how it went down for you?
Yeah, it was crazy. You know, we started the race, normally have a launch control, and I was having to start without it in the second start, and it kind of made me panic for a little bit, but we ended up getting an awesome start. The track was pretty sketchy, slippery, that stuff down in turn one. But that was some of the best racing I've had, especially on the Superbike with Martin. And when I saw Hayes go by me, I panicked and stepped it up big time and almost high side, and then realized he had the 5 second penalty. So I kind of, you know, came back to realize I need to slow down a little bit and just battle with Martin. And it was a great race. So thanks to everybody, and can't wait for tomorrow.
So he was aware of that 5 second penalty all along. Certainly with the red flag, he had that information. And here is the way we come up with a finish at New Jersey Motorsports Park with yet two more races, another sport bike, another super bike to go. This is turning out to be an incredible event. And you can imagine with what you've seen already, what you are going to see later today. Danielle?
The number 54, Roger Hayden, was sitting second place before the red flag, and you said you'd like to be there throughout the rest of the race, and you ended up finishing second. Congratulations.
Yeah, thanks. You know, it's just a testament to the team, the whole National Guard. Michael Jordan Motorsports team did a great job. We struggled a little bit yesterday, and, you know, today we were fighting for a win. I definitely felt a little better before the red flag came out, but, you know, it's a second. It's good. You know, it's the way our season's been going. We've been in a hunt every race for wins, and we just got to keep it going.
And so, boy, what a day it has been. I think we're going to be talking about this for a very long time. Not only what the race was today, but what it did for the championship and what it has done for the points. One thing that's done is give Josh Herrin a chance at a championship. We said it starting. If Herrin wins one race and finishes second, the others, then Herrin will win by 6 points. He may be on his way to do that. For Scott Russell, Danielle Teal, and our entire team, I'm Paul Page. This has been a presentation of Chet Burks Productions in association with CBS Sports Network. Josh Herrin has taken the win here today.